Joseph Nyakayiro, 60 years old, is a resident of Burungu Karambi, North Region in Fort Poto City. He was diagnosed with breast cancer in his right breast in 2019. Luckily, he sought medical help immediately, and in 2021, he underwent surgery to remove the cancer tumor. In January 2022, he started chemotherapy and he later received radiotherapy. Currently, Nyakayiro goes for medical review after 3 months as he shares his story.
He took me to Mulago, the Department of Makerere University, Department of Pathology. Pathology, he took me there. They did the checkup. They gave me a report. At the end, they found me have cancer. That was terrible. I thought I'm already finished, I'm going to die. Then from there, the good thing, the doctor consoled me. He consoled me, he gave me advice, he gave me every advice of what? If it is cancer, if it is still young, we are going to treat you, to put you on treatment. Then he said, he gave me advice to operate, to bring out the tumor. It was on my breast there. Then he checked on my breast. Then we agreed. He gave me another appointment. He came in for Porto here. I prepared myself with my wife. Then we went back for surgery.
Given that men have very little breast tissue, the cancer spreads rapidly to the chest wall. This results in men being diagnosed with the disease in advanced stages. The commonest age group for these patients is seen between 40 to 50 years, with a mean age of about 45 years, as Nixon Nionzima, who heads research and training at the Uganda Cancer Institute, explains.
Our experience is that men also get breast cancer. 10% of the patients with breast cancer that we see at the Uganda Cancer Institute are men. Of course, challengingly, men have very little breast tissue. So one, because of the very little breast tissue, breast cancer in men spreads quite rapidly and spreads the chest wall. So most men we see have relatively advanced cancers, but we're still able to manage breast cancer in men. In a year, we have between 800 and 900 new breast cancer cases at the Uganda Cancer Institute, and these 10% are men, so that is about 80 to 90 men that we see every year with breast cancer at the Uganda Cancer Institute.
Highlighting the signs and symptoms of breast cancer in men, Dr. Nionzima says the signs that men present are similar to those of women. Any abnormal enlargement, swelling of the breast, is a sign for having the breast checked.
The telltale signs are still similar. One is, of course, if you have an abnormal swelling, abnormal enlargement of the breast, it is really a sign for you to go and get the breast checked. Commonly, of course, when we're doing sensitization, we speak about women doing a soft breast exam, but it's actually much easier for a man to see a swelling in a breast than it is for a woman, because again, you have very little breast tissue, so you're able to see any abnormal swelling in the breast. So any swelling, usually unilateral, that is affecting one breast, is a sign for you to go and get your breast examined.
Just like women, the same treatment modalities are given for men. For example, surgery, chemotherapy, hormonotherapy, and depending on the characteristics of the tumor, they are given targeted therapy and radiotherapy.
When breast cancer is detected early, either in stage 1 or stage 2, it's curable. When the lesion is still confined to the breast, you can have surgery and have complete excision of the tumor, and that is complete cure. However, if, like in most cases, men come with advanced stage disease, it has spread, again, because our men have poor health-seeking habits. Even when we go out for screening, 90% will be women, about 5% will be men, maybe the other 5% children. But if men can adopt health-seeking habits, better health-seeking habits, if you have first degree relatives with breast cancer, go and get checked out. If you've had relatives who had developed breast cancer under 35 years, go and get checked out.
The side effects of chemotherapy are one of the biggest challenges that men grapple with. They lose their hair, nails, and their skin darkens, and they get nausea and vomiting, weight loss, as well as diarrhea.
The same. So the men do suffer the same side effects as women. Of course, the only difference is that men don't get pregnant, so we don't have pregnancy-associated side effects, but otherwise the side effects are the same.
So the
other thing is hair. Yes, they lose hair, their nails darken, they get nausea and vomiting, they lose weight, they get sores sometimes, depending on the therapy that you have. Sometimes they have diarrhea, but the side effects, the spectrum is the same because the treatments are the same.
All hope is not lost. Dr. Niyonzima says there are modalities to combat each side effect as they present. Every year, the Institute registers between 800 to 900 breast cancer patients annually. This translates into about 80 to 90 men being diagnosed with breast cancer at the Uganda Cancer Institute. Dr. Niyonzima explains why every man is at risk of developing breast cancer.
Any man is at risk of breast cancer. But those who are prone are those who usually have first degree or second degree relatives who have had breast cancer. Be it male or female. You're at more risk if you've had a male relative with breast cancer, but if you've had your mother, if you've had your sister have breast cancer, you're at a higher risk of breast cancer. And that's because some breast cancers are hereditary. There's a gene, they're called BRCA, that is associated with breast cancer and ovarian cancer in women, but is also associated with prostate cancer and breast cancer in men.
Cancer experts affirm that men too suffer from the disease, as data from Uganda Cancer Institute reveals that about 10% of the patient population with breast cancer in Uganda are men. Breast cancer is a cancer that starts in the breast. When advanced, the disease can spread to other parts of the body, such as the backbone, lungs, and the liver. Report compiled by Agnes Chotarengedire for the news.